So you want to talk about a fitting substitution? And look at us! Only a couple weeks removed from Independence Day, Shane in your face is still in the holiday spirit. And Old Glory waving high. What do you think of this pick, Jayworth?
I think it's a great choice by Jock Samson. I'm glad that there weren't more options because I don't think this crowd can count that high.
And one thing about Shane, he is absolutely a proud American through and through.
Really? I didn't pick up on it from the attire and flag and beard, Joe. Could you elaborate?
I will say I feel bad for Magnum CK. I wish he could be here. That attack, that assault was completely unjustified. I'm not sure if that was Argos and Dupree who perpetrated it, but certainly they attempted to reap the benefits one way or the other.
We have no proof that it was them. The attack did not occur in metric, so I don't know where everyone's jumping to this conclusion.
How did an attack occur in metric?
I'll explain it after the show.
The fans are pointing out that one team's is bigger than the others. Flags, I mean.
Yeah, it's not the size.
Look at Argos and Dupree making a beeline for the flag.
Well, that's how you win.
Well, yeah, but you're supposed to, like, have a match first.
At no point in the contract does it say, have a match and get the flag. It just says, get the flag.
Well, I think the match is kind of understood because Jock and Shane want to beat the hell out of these guys.
Well, that's their prerogative. Clearly, Team Storm has a different one. Now, it may not be going the way Team Storm wants it to go right now, but...
Argos, the victim of the trademark Jock Samson eye poke. And this is going to be a wild matchup because you have to incapacitate both of your opponents to climb up and get that flag. Jock channeling an IWC legend, former IWC Tag Champion Jim Duggan.
Yeah, and Shane in your face whipping Dupree with a fan shirt. So...
I bet the shirt was made in America, though. That child was made in America.
Jock Samson just stole a baby. Okay. I've seen a lot of things used as weapons. I was a little worried.
Well, yeah, Jock Samson's a bit of a wild personality, tough to tame. Jock has found a different child. It's manhandling him. What in the world?
Is he the weapon?
Double clothesline. Well, I guess there's no disqualifications if the only way to win is to capture the flag.
I guess.
Thanks to that gentleman, we know that kid is 13.
We don't know that. He didn't produce a birth certificate. He could have just picked a number. We're making a lot of suppositions here.
Argos has Shane in the ring. Dupree dealing with Jock on the outside. Do not try to throw fists with Shane in your face. Undefeated amateur MMA record. A couple of times, nearly captured the Super Indy title as Shane measures the most brash and annoying member of the IWC roster. Keep in mind, Jayworth, Jack Pollock not at ringside with his Team Storm compatriots. He's preparing for an IWC championship match later tonight with Wardlow.
Well, here we go. No.
Shane reaching for this flag. Dupree gets involved, and that's the danger of this matchup. You get one opponent neutralized, there could be another waiting in the wings.
And can we talk for a moment about who came out with Shane in your face?
That would be Anya.
Anya. I was going to go with Lady Liberty.
We'll call her Lady Liberty. That works. Oh, Dupree, after hiding behind Lady Liberty. sneaks out with a clothesline. You only like these fans when they agree with you, don't you?
That's the only time I like anybody, Joe.
Oh.
It's why we don't get along.
Oh, wait a second. Argos is crawling towards the flags. Shane is down.
And Jock is moving at top Jock Samson speed to intercept.
Yeah, Jock is, he's not going to set any records running the 40.
No.
But he's found Argos. He's got there in time.
Jock is a lot of things. Land speed champion, he is not. You don't expect a man of Jock's physical stature to be a leopard out there on the Serengeti. Leopards are fast.
There's nowhere to land that feels good here as Argos and Jock Samson struggling for leverage and momentum here. A good 8-10. Oh! Jock counters with a dab! And the dab
is up there.
The dab has knocked Argos clear out. And now Jock gonna retrieve his flag and I'll do Dupree from behind downstairs.
Now in your face, back to the ring, but Dupree up.
Oh, Dupree's too far gone. He's gonna get it. Dupree got the flag. Team Storm retrieves their colors. And unfortunately, America has lost a flag match, and it's a rarity in wrestling history. But Dupree and Argos get to wave their colors high and celebrate with another victory.
First the War of 1812, and now this, Joe.
And you gotta believe, though, that if Magnum CK were healthy, if the Mega Powers were here in full, the result might have been different. Shane and Jock did what they could, but they're just not a regular tag team, bottom line. Who took Magnum CK out? Was it Team Storm? Was it not? We're not really sure, but certainly the benefits were reaped by Argos and Dupree tonight. After hand-choosing Shane as a partner, a frustrated Jock Samson leaves Shane behind.
Well, we know Jock's a bit of a hothead.
He's a hothead. He's patriotic. He feels like he's let the fans down. He's let America down.
He'll calm down. It'll be okay.
Hopefully it does, but this was not the feel-good tag team that Jock Samson hoped for. Team Storm victorious.
Hello? Oh. Hi, IWC. Did you miss us?
Did you miss us?
Who cares? Because the fraternity is still the kings of IWC Tag Team Wrestling. Can I get another?